Okay, well, that was fucking terrible, actually. The game immediately crashed. I have no idea if it's going to go any better this time. I'm just gonna pull this up and hope that it works like it did in testing when I tested it and it worked. Who is Funcom and did they do anything besides this series? Yeah, they did. Just a moment. Funcom is a publisher, actually. They published an absolute ton of games. I'm just pulling. They're a developer and a publisher. They did Age of Conan, The Secret World, Anarchy Online. They published just absolute tons of games. Recently, they published Metal Hellsinger, which you may have heard of. So let me see if this actually works this time. Start the game. Hello. Glad to be back. Okay. So is my mouse moving on this screen? Because I do not see it moving. And I don't see things changing when I. It is not. Okay. I am gonna have to play it in a smaller window and just stretch this to fit, perhaps. Perhaps this will work. This seems to work. All right, it looks like I'm gonna have to play it in a window and, do things that way. That's rough. Well, if I happen to miss any hotspots, this is why. Let me do a quick sound test. Y'all can hear the music. You can hear the sound effects. And you can hear April's amazing sound test.
Hello, testing 1, 1, 2, 42.
All right, well, let's go ahead and get started then. That's not what I expected, but
so, you've come to hear me tell a story, have you?
If you please, we would love to hear one of your stories. You have seen so much. You have lived so long.
Oh, so good of you to remind me of my age, child.
You're old, Grandma.
No, don't worry. I am an old woman, but I've lived a long and fulfilling life, and I do have stories to tell. Which story would you like to hear?
A true one. A true story.
All my stories are true, child. There are enough fairy tales in the worlds already. There's no need for me to make up more, believe me.
Tell us the story of the balance, then.
You want the story of the balance? Oh, that's a long story, child. And not one I'd venture to tell at this hour. But perhaps I could tell you a story that I heard a long time ago. A story that became a crucial turning point in the history of the balance. And that set in motion wheels that, to this day, are still turning.
Please, yes, that does sound like a story we'd like to hear.
Very well. This story, like all good stories, begins where it ends, in a tower. In a realm that is no more.
So I want you all to know that I fucking hate that kid. I hate his Hornstar mustache, I hate his stupid hat, and I hate the way his voice sounds like he's 12 when he looks like he's 40. I hate that kid so much. Aside from that, this is gorgeous. It's the worst hat short of, like, the Kolovian helm from Morrowind. My dude looks like he has a 2-foot-tall mohawk. I don't think we've been told that, Penguin. I don't know what you heard, but... Sure, whatever. Aw, man, I hate when I wake up and I'm part of a mural. And he who controls the spikes controls the universe. Terry, that would be because this is in fact the late 90s, early 2000s. This game was released in 1999, which is the pinnacle of the late 90s, early 2000s. Meanwhile, in Blade Runner, I hate when people steal my bed.
Oh no. Don't tell me I'm dreaming again.
You know, for once, just once, it would be nice to have a decent night's sleep without waking up screaming from a bad dream at 4 a.m.
So this is our heroine, April O'Neil, April Ryan. Not April O'Neil. I always do that. Him.
There's a storm heading this way. Even the weather sucks in my dreams. I feel so charmed. It's a pristine and picture-perfect dawn.
Yeah, Ragnar Tornquist in particular loves this game. It's his child. Oh, here's April.
I'm in my undies. That's so not appropriate.
Here's April. Ryan's underwear.
What's happening? Oh, perfect. I guess if I don't do something to save that egg, I'll suffer 7 years of bad karma or something.
7 years of bad karma. Remember when somebody could say that with a straight face? I don't think that you could say that now.
Lucky thing the egg got caught between those roots. It's a long way down.
Big egg. Showtime.
It looks reptilian, but it can't be. It's much, much too big and... I don't much care for reptiles.
Can't reach the egg as far as I can tell. Not that she's willing to exert herself.
Oh, that's some chick. I don't think I can get a good grip on it. It's too big and slippery, and I might drop it by accident.
Oh well. But yeah, I do vaguely remember this tutorial.
It's a nest, padded with large scales, very large scales. For some strange reason, I have a feeling I should get the hell out of here before the tenants return.
It's a large scale nest. Unfortunately, it does seem to be rather small for a large scale nest.
This is interesting. I've never seen a scale this size before.
It's cool. Everything is to scale. And that goes into April's magical paper sheet of holding.
I'm an artist, not a botanist, but I'm pretty certain this tree is dead, or close to it.
Well, we're learning valuable things about April. Like that, you know, she's not a doctor.
Something happened to this rock quite recently, and it probably altered the course of the stream. Hey, maybe that's why the tree's dying.
And that she can put two and two together and, you know, get four. Ooh, free branch.
The suffering we must endure.
What?
Why do you take such pleasure in torturing us?
Torturing you? Who are you?
We are the voice of all trees, the spirit of wood and leaf.
You're a talking tree?
No, a tree does not talk. At least not in your tongue. The tongue of trees is the language of wood, root, and leaf.
Who are you then?
Like we said, we are the voice of all trees. Whenever an injustice is done, we must speak for the tree if we are present.
But you're the Lorax, got
it. It's the branch. I shouldn't have broken the branch off.
Oh, what does it matter anyway? There is nothing more to be done for us. We are simply here to provide comfort in the final passing to Earth.
We? I only see one of you.
We are one with our host, as we are all one spirit, but legion.
Yeah, thanks for clearing that up.
We do not expect you to understand. You are human.
Welcome to the conversation system of The Longest Journey, where you talk to people and they talk back at you for half an hour and then you can talk to them again. We can talk to this Lemon Pledge looking mofo for a while about Tree and the egg and who he is and... Right now we're most concerned with the
What's
egg.
What's the deal with the egg?
Egg? What egg? Oh, of course, the child. Whenever the mother was absent, we were entrusted with the safety of the child. But now, withered and without strength, we can do nothing to help. We have failed the mother, and we despair. Our shame knows no bounds.
You know, I kind of question the mother that leaves a tree as a babysitter. Even if it is, you know, the spirit of all trees, which appears to be this one and this one. April, your dream landscape is kind of screwed up, you know?
What happened to the tree?
Oh, the pain.
Oh, the pain.
Battle?
Between the mother and Black Chaos. She was only protecting her child, but it would not back down, and the force of their battle shook the mountain. The brook that fed us was led astray, and without water, we began to wither and die.
Who are you again?
We are the Wood Spirit. We come to all trees in the hour of great need to provide comfort and aid in the passing to Earth, and to give a voice to those who suffer. Our time is running out as we speak. The passing to Earth is about to begin. Leave us now.
What about the egg?
Oh, it is too late. Without sustenance, we do not have the strength to bring it safely home. We have failed. And the Earth will know our shame for all time to come.
Okay, so I forgot that April, like, automatically asks the last question in line. If there's only one remaining. So, that was kind of interestingly timed. Like, oh no, the hunt! The Earth, we are dying! Who are you again? Like, wow, that is some short-term memory.
Are you always this glum?
We are here because it is too late. The passing has begun. Leave us. Please.
Isn't there anything I can do to help?
Oh, we do not expect a human to come to our aid.
Lose the attitude, okay? Just tell me if there's anything I can do.
It is futile. We need water, but there is none. Not after the brook changed course.
I'll find a way. Don't panic.
We do not panic. Unlike you, we accept our destiny. If, however, against all odds, you do succeed, we will carry the child safely back into its nest. Do not make a foolish attempt on your own. It would spell certain misery.
So in spite of Baron Sulco von Woodface's eternal pessimism, being a human, we do have opposable thumbs, unlike him.
Not a botanist, but I'm pretty certain this tree is dead, or close to it.
Which means we're capable of constructing...
I think I just made a funnel. Cool! I'm so proud of myself.
Elaborate machinery. Which we can use to get the water flowing again.
This should do the trick.
Really, this is just cameo elements of power again. Also, man, that's some fast-acting water. Yeah, like, do not... It takes, like, 2 seconds, man. Not really a struggle. So now we can, like, lips at the tree.
Hello? Hello?
Leave us be.
Are you okay?
We find our strength returned. And so we have no time for idle conversation. We must drink and rejoice.
Aren't we forgetting something?
Hush, listen. The song of ancient wood. Is it not sweet?
Sweet, definitely. Yeah, the baby's probably ready to boogie down as well.
The baby? Oh, the egg. Thank the Earth. We almost forgot.
Yo, thank me, not the Earth.
Uh-oh.
There we go. Egg in the pot.
What? What was that? Uh-oh.
It is you. You have come.
You know me?
April, daughter, I have been waiting for you.
Waiting? Why?
Because it begins here, with you, as it always has.
What do you mean?
The breach and the mending, the pain and the joy, the end of the old and the dawn of the new. A different world. I am the mother of what is, but you, you are the mother of a future that may yet be.
How will I know? How will I know what to do?
I will guide you, and I will protect you as much as I can. But in the end, you are on your own.
I'm afraid.
You always were, my child, my daughter.
So, there would be a dragon alert here, except I didn't want to cover up all of her lines.
This is probably not a good thing.
Yeah, welcome to MTV's Liquid Television, folks. This has some incredibly 90s CGI.
What a nightmare. I'm completely exhausted. I must have been tossing and turning all night. So hot in here, too. No wonder I keep having these weird dreams. I've basically been simmering in my own sweat every night this past week. Doesn't look like it's gonna cool down anytime soon, either. It's another sunny day in Newport.
April is referred to as the daughter of a dragon.
It's a good thing the studio's got proper air conditioning. I promised myself I was gonna spend most of the day working, and I don't intend to break that promise. Not this time.
So, that said, April, maybe you'd be a little less hot if you didn't wear gigantic clunky boots to bed? Let's see. We do not have, any dragon scales in our inventory. We do have...
My cash card at the moment is really quite useless. There can't be more than a dollar or two left in it.
April is just a poor girl from a poor family. Well, I'm not going to say that. I might be contradicted. So, April, how are you feeling about your underwear in the real world?
Big surprise. I'm still here.
Yes, you are. So, there is a lot of world building in The Longest Journey. So we're going to take some time and, you know, look around at stuff like her posters and her paintings.
That's my work. It's supposed to be a portrait of my life study teacher, but I think he might disagree.
Yeah, it kind of looks like that guy from The Shape of Water.
That fan is supposed to keep the room nice and cool in the summer. Sure, yeah, it's at least, one quarter of a degree cooler in here when it's on.
When it's on, which is not always. No, I think that was her torso.
That's my desk, so, theoretically, that's where I'm supposed to do my work. I think my muse has departed me for greener pastures, though, because lately, inspiration's been fleeting at best.
So she's an artist, she's art-blocked. You know, what else is new?
Shelves.
Oh, okay, cool.
The wardrobe is actually made of real wood, and not that synthetic crap that makes me sneeze and itch all over.
April Wyan. God, this almost been April O'Neil. She is allergic to fake wood. I don't know what material that would be.
Alright, so my wardrobe's sort of chic deficient, but I can't afford to be cutting edge. Useful, practical, and cheap is my shopping mantra.
Cool.
It's Constable Guybrush, my toy ape. He doesn't much like being called monkey.
So here's a dual reference. We've got a reference to Guybrush Threepwood, and we've got a reference to the orangutan librarian from Discworld who does not like being called a monkey. Anyway, let's take our toy monkey from childhood along with us.
It's a bunch of drawings I drew when I was a kid. I don't even know why I brought them here. They mean absolutely nothing to me.
Sure, April.
I could only carry one suitcase with me when I left home. There was so much I would have loved to bring, but c'est la vie. At least it was a clean break with my past. I guess when all my hard work starts paying off, I'll get a house and fill it with all kinds of new junk. The past, who needs it?
Yeah, I relate to April only being able to bring one suitcase when she left home. Anyway, the sound hiccuped there for a minute, concerning me.
I'm not good at taking care of living things, but this plant's doing just fine despite months of neglect.
It's plastic. And there's a window.
Nice view, if you're into brickwork.
Which we can open. And lean out of. And look! Canals!
Spiky.
And spikes. And,
whatever those pipes are spewing out, I know one thing for sure, it ain't water. I still haven't figured out what runs through the canals in Venice, but I'm sure it can't be water.
Oop.
It's a rubber ducky, helplessly trapped under that rusty old grill.
This must be the famous rubber duck puzzle that everybody tells me about. I actually know very little about this game, so presumably we'll figure out how to get that later, or I won't. One way or the other. Let's see.
My on-again, off-again diary. We've had a turbulent relationship, her and I.
Well, let's scoop it up. April's diary. Can we get access? Oh, this diary is from Mist.
I've been keeping a diary intermittently since I was 5 years old. Not the same one, of course. I started this one, I think, April of this year.
Ah, so it's April's April diary.
Hey, it's my timesheet from the cafe. I completely forgot I put it in here. Good thing I found it, because I'm broke.
Oh, good. We can get April some money.
It's my diary.
And we're not allowed to read her diary. Okay. Well, I kind of had hope. But no, we can't go invading her personal life. We'll do plenty of that as the game progresses, I'm sure.
It's a picture of me and my friends.
Okay. Some books.
I'm part of the should be reading more, but life's too short generation. We embrace our illiteracy.
Can't relate.
The last book I read was How to Seduce the Man of Your Dreams. Now, if I can just find a man to dream about, I'll be all set.
How about you find a dragon to dream about instead?
I had to borrow some posters from the cafe, because I just can't afford to buy any of my own.
Oh.
When I think about it, that's so depressing. I'd better head over to the studio to do some work. Only 2 weeks until the big show opens, and my contribution is in serious need of attention.
Are you gonna wear that?
Might be a good idea to get dressed first, though.
Okay, good. That's not much more, April. Okay.
Hey, babe. Babe, you're looking real sexy today.
Zach, listen, I've gotta run, and...
What's going on, April? How you been?
Let's see, we could be wishy-washy, compliant, or downright rude. I know which one is more fun.
I was doing just fine until you came along.
What's that? Listen, I was thinking maybe you and I could hook up tonight, go to the pavilion or something.
He's listening.
We could pop a few raptures, do a little close dancing. How about it?
Just, you know, wow, I'm so glad that we're being listened to in this relationship.
Let me think about it.
So, think about it, babe. But don't keep thinking too long or I'll be gone. There are other birds in the sea, you know? Gotta go.
That's cool, bye. I'm heartbroken. Apparently, fuck off.
What an asshole.
Thanks, April. Let's see. We get anything around here that...
Organic plastic. It grows, and it converts carbon dioxide into oxygen, just like real plants, but it doesn't need nourishment of any kind. Convenient, but disturbing.
We have it? Yes. I'm gonna be honest, I don't know why I did that. We'll find out! I honestly don't remember, like, 99% of this game, even the parts that
it's
I played.
It's a fact, as an FACT, Free Access Terminal.
It's a fact, Jack. And it... even the shoe bill is already
Computer,
taken.
Voice interface is not installed. Please use the touchscreen interface to communicate with this Free Access Terminal.
Oh, okay.
Why not consider a very reasonable upgrade? In addition to a voice interface, True Holo display technology and Instacredit compatibility.
No, I'll just use my hands, thanks.
You are missing out on a great opportunity. If you upgrade now...
Hold on. You understood that. You have a voice interface installed already. Why would I pay to have another one installed?
Current voice interface is for sales purposes only. If you take advantage of this very affordable upgrade today...
No, really. You... This terminal doesn't belong to me.
Noted. Please refrain from voice communication in the future, or you will be reported to the FACT FUB and charged for processing time.
FUB?
Fair Use Bureau. They are authorized to carry deadly arms.
Well, whatever. Sorry.
So, if we speak to the computer too much, it will call men in to shoot us. There's a lot to be said about that. I'm not gonna say it. Anyway, April apparently doesn't actually want to touch it, so let's just move on. Charlie's apartment, Zach's apartment. What are we on, the Power Rangers? Downstairs. Okay. We probably don't need to go into anybody else's apartment. Okay, I forgot that you can double-click to run. Let's see if we can get out of here without being talked to. Okay, let's see what we've got on the board.
I'm sorry, but big sweaty jocks do not turn me on. I'll take a nerd any day.
April, I think that's an ostrich.
I can't tell what that note's saying as long as it's up there. Fiona's handwriting is not particularly legible.
Oh, okay. Well, let's pull down the note and read it.
Found. A gold ring under the common room sofa. If it's yours, let me know. But no false claims, please. Fiona. I did lose a gold ring a few weeks ago. I hope this is the one. I'll have to ask Fiona about it.
Okay, so that's a relief. We might have a claim on a gold ring. That's valuable. We could pawn that.
Annual summer blowout at the Fringe Cafe. Friday, August 4th, 8 p.m. Free food. Live performances by Royne Dale. Harlequin Masquerade. The Go-Getters. Tickets available at the bar. $10 only. Spread the word.
I don't know if any of those are actual bands. Probably not. They just sound like bands.
Look, it's Monkey Boy!
Okay.
Pizza and movie night, Monday, July 31st. BYOS. BYO what? Soap?
No, bring your own soup. Why aren't you shopping for soup at movie night?
Common room, duty roster, July 27th. April and Emma. Oh joy, manual labor, my favorite.
Let's...
Be considerate. Keep the volume down after 11 p.m. Fiona.
Okay, well, it doesn't sound like you're being asked to do all that much here, April. And looks like we're gonna have to talk to people. Bring your own subtitles. Yeah. Could be.
The omnipresent screen. I don't pretend to know how it works, but all the data apparently passes through tiny little black holes in the fabric of our dimension. You know, that really freaks me out when I think about it.
From where? Why? What? Yeah, I actually want to know more about that one. If only April had done more reading.
Emma picked this table up at a flea market for $10 last month. That's $9 more than it's worth.
Yo, it's a flat surface. Don't knock it.
It's a matchbook.
Well, steal it. No one will ever know.
Shelves.
Oh, we're gonna hear shelves a lot, I think.
It's a chair.
Alright, shelves, a chair. We have so much technology around us. Let's talk to Fiona.
They really knew how to design tacky furniture back in the late 22nd century.
I wish.
Morning, Fiona.
Good morning, darling. You're up early.
Yeah, I couldn't sleep.
Are you feeling all right? You look a little pale.
So April apparently sounds a lot different when she's talking to people, as opposed to talking to herself. Again, I can relate.
I just have a lot of work to do.
For the exhibition. How's that going, darling?
Good.
God, what are you, one of Celine's Animal Crossing characters?
It's going.
Stop calling me darling.
It's not going so well. I haven't felt inspired in a long time. Weeks. I'm scared that I'll never... What would happen if I just... ran out of creativity, Fiona? What if I can't ever finish a painting again? Oh God, I've chosen the wrong line of work.
Oh darling, no, no. I just think you work too hard. I worry about you all the time, you know.
Don't.
Well, darling, I do. You should work less and play more. When was the last time you had a boyfriend?
God, don't remind me. That's a depressing thought.
Well, there you are. Live. Enjoy your youth. It goes by too quickly as it is.
Yeah, you'd know, wouldn't you?
Ooh, that's uncalled for. That's downright mean, April. I'm in a mind to kick your ass for that one, and I've won tougher fights, believe me.
Yeah, April is kind of a pool noodle. Also, we got four darlings and a suggestion to go get fucked. Good talk, ma'am. Good talk.
Where's everybody this morning?
Mickey's tied up in the basement. Mind you, she's not literally tied up, of course. Although, that is a tempting thought.
Are you getting into your sexual fantasies here, Fiona? Because it's a little too early in the morning for that, don't you think?
Sorry, I just can't help myself.
Yeah, this is an adult game.
Anyway, the plumbing is... You probably noticed when you took a shower, yeah? There's no hot water. So Mickey's working on that. Getting knee-deep in putrid canal water is her job. Thank God.
What about Charlie? He up yet?
No, he's still sleeping. And Emma just went to bed. I saw her come in when I was making breakfast. Do you know who she's seeing now?
I don't know. Some guy?
Those lads I see her with, darling. She's too good for those assholes. I wish she'd find herself a man who'd treat her right for once.
She hasn't had much luck with love, no?
She's a magnet for creeps. And she's so pretty. They prey on her, you know, bastards.
I've tried to talk to her about it, but Emma's impulsive. She doesn't listen.
She's just as headstrong as you and me, darling. But I'm sure she'll be all right. She's smart and resourceful, and not afraid to speak up for herself.
That's 5 darlings so far. Let's see if we can hit, like, 10 before the conversation's over.
Shouldn't you be outside enjoying the good weather?
You joking? Bollocks to that. I'll stay inside until September, thank you very much. It's too bloody hot.
Ma'am, are you Daphne from Frasier?
Can I ask you a few questions?
Why, certainly, darling. About what?
We can ask about people and the house and the apartment and Newport and... I'm not going to right now.
Don't hesitate asking if there's something else you want to know.
Yeah, when I said that every conversation in The Longest Journey is the longest conversation, I wasn't kidding.
I'd better get going. Off to school. Yeah, there are no more classes this semester, but I have to finish my painting by next Thursday.
For what it's worth, darling, good luck. And don't work too hard, all right?
Don't worry, I'm hardly working. hey, about this gold ring?
I saw this note on the corkboard. I think the ring might belong to me.
I'm sorry I have to ask, but could you describe the ring?
Sure thing. It says Sweet 16. My dad gave it to me. I think it was the only birthday of mine he remembered, or at least acknowledged.
Yes, that's the one. I found it under the sofa when I was vacuuming. Here you are, darling.
Thanks. It's not worth much, but it's got a certain sentimental value for me.
It's a very pretty ring.
Yeah, it is. My dad never gave me anything pretty before or since. He must have won a poker game or something that day. You know, it's strange. I don't hate him. He's a bastard and he treated me like crap almost every single day of my life. But I don't hate him. I feel sorry for him.
Why?
Because he doesn't know how to love. Can't love anybody or anything, and because he'll be miserable every second of every minute of every day until the day he dies. God, I'm glad that life is behind me. I hope I never have to see him again. No, that doesn't sound right. I've made a choice not to see him again. Ever.
You know, on second thought, April's great. I love April. So, let's get out of here and get out to the school so we can... Alright, well, let's take a look around out here first.
I love this mural. Even though the motif is a little trite. I mean, fairy tale forests and magical dragons? Still, it's pretty.
Nope.
I wonder what happened to the artist. Probably making a bundle from cheesy fantasy calendars and book covers.
Nope, April can get back in the sea. Nope. Oh boy, I get to look at the left window and the right window.
Hey, wow, I can see right into the common room. That's amazing.
Is it? Okay.
The shades are drawn.
Good, we can't see into anybody's apartment. Can we circle around the side of the house, apartment, building? Oh, we can fuck with whatever this is.
I'd guess that's a pressure gauge. It's at 100. That's percent, I guess. 100% pressure?
That's bad, isn't it? That feels bad. Maybe we should...
It's a rusty old wheel. I'd imagine it turns the water on and off.
It won't budge. The pressure's probably too high.
Let's... Ooh, no, that's actually a bad idea.
Oh. It seems the clamp served a purpose after all. What a surprise.
All right, what if we,
What a mystifying contraption, and completely absurd. What are all these valves and wheels and thingamajigs for? What grand purpose does it all serve?
Well, I imagine this is your water heater.
The water tank's full.
Is it a bare exposed wire?
That cable's been ripped in two. The cables are too far apart to tie them back together. Looks like a big piece of cable was torn off.
Can we like wrap that in plastic, maybe? No. Well, let's try to ignore that this thing is gonna fucking kill us in a few days. And just go off, hey.
That's Cortez. He sits in the same spot almost every day. I hate to admit it, but he scares me a little.
Use the toy monkey on the cave. Alright, well, that is worth a shot. Constable Guybrush, can you repair these cables? Seems not. Can you pinch this tube? Oh, okay. Do I have anything else that might... No, not really. Well, we'll mark that down as our first puzzle. What is this machine?
Oye,
how do we...
Señorita.
Yes?
How are you this morning, Señorita Bonita?
I cannot save my game. I'm in a conversation.
Hot.
I see. The summers in Newport are never pleasant. And it will get worse before it gets better. They say there's another heat wave headed our way.
Yeah, well, yesterday you said you'd call
source. Yeah, so I heard. So, you gonna be all right? You don't look dressed for the weather.
Si Dios quiere. Sunshine and pretty señoritas give an old man like me the blues. I like my days cold and rainy. In fact, I think I prefer the world to be in black and white.
Like an old movie.
Like all good movies. But tell me, Señorita Ryan, how would you describe your perfect day?
Honestly, I'd rather be too cold than too hot.
Cold and rainy like yours.
Está bien. We are alike, you and I. But this heat is not why you are unhappy, no? You are troubled by nightmares.
What?
You are afraid of them. You even fear your dreams may be real.
Who told you about my nightmares?
No one. I can tell from looking into your eyes. I see the ghosts that haunt you.
I don't know who you've been talking to, but from now on, stay the hell away from me in my personal life.
No puedo, señorita Ryan. You have a destiny.
Destiny? I don't care what you think. Just leave me alone.
If you don't face them, I'm afraid your nightmares will continue. Soon they will appear to you even when you're awake.
You need some serious help, you know that?
We all do, April. That's the reason we are here, you and me.
That's it. I don't have to listen to this.
Perdóname. I've upset you. We didn't think you'd react this way. I hope we can talk again soon.
I don't think so, no.
Please, think about it. And señorita, cuidado. Be careful.
Let me figure out how to... Option, save game. Okay. Oh, hey, here's the April's Diary... button. And a conversation log, which, you know... Yay. April's Diary. I will read... You know what? I will read that later. I promise. Right now, let's take it to the bridge.
From what I've been told, the clock stopped on the very day of the infamous Venice Massacre in 2109, to the minute the police opened fire on the squatters.
Yeah, the world building in this game isn't always subtle, exactly. I have no idea where to go now. Oh well, presumably April does. She'll stop me if I get it wrong. To the subway.
East Venice. There are, I think, 3 subway stops in Venice, including this one.
I want to know exactly what it took to get a subway built in Venice. You know?
It's a plaque commemorating the Venice Massacre of 2109. It reads, "In honor of those who died defending our right to live." I wonder what the homeless people do in the wintertime. Supposedly, it gets biting cold here in Newport, and I don't know if there are any shelters anymore.
And then there's a park over here. I don't know if I need to be here in the park. I'm just exploring. It's been a long time since I played
this. Those freight trains pass by at least once every 5 minutes all day long. You get used to it, though, eventually. This guy's out here all day long, all year. He never stops painting. Ever. And I doubt he's ever finished even one painting.
Yeah, that's dedication, you know? Anyway, there's the Academy. Oh. Yeah, there's a... As a speculative fiction game, there is a lot in this game that is too real. From April's relationship with her dad to, you know, the massacres.
It's the official VAVA notice board. Only registered students are allowed to put notices up here.
VAVA. Venice... Academy of Modern Art? No, Venice Academy of... Venetian Art?
The Venice Academy of the Visual Arts.
That was gonna be my next guess.
Prestigious, expensive, and my future alma mater, if all goes well with the exhibition and I get my grant, that is.
Yeah, visual art, it turns out. Like I said, that was going to be my next guess.
Bishop and Anne-Marie. He's a photography student. She's in my life study class. Nice couple. No, I've got too much to do right now.
I can't talk to people. I have things to do.
That's Mary Sam, VAVA's founding mother and pro-Venice activist back before the riots. She was assassinated by a corporate hired gun right after the school opened some 90 years ago.
I mean... In a lot of ways, April lives in, you know, the cyberpunk universe, or as I alluded to, possibly Blade Runner. Hello, here's a rubber glove.
Somebody's thrown away a rubber glove.
It's mine now.
Why would somebody toss out a perfectly good work glove with just one big hole in it? What a terrible, terrible waste.
One big hole directly in the palm. Can we put the organic plastic in the glove to patch that? No? Well, I thought I'd try.
It's empty.
Can I scavenge anything else in the trash bins? Wait, what? Student.
Olav's on a roll. Again. Does that guy ever run out of inspiration or energy? Must be the cold Norwegian winters. Nothing else to do but... paint.
Blade Runner, but it's postmodern France. That is the Capcom game Remember Me, which ironically most people forget about.
Art books. There's a really nice one here on Turner. I love his landscapes.
Yeah, I think Venice is in Italy, actually.
Nice. Very Van Gogh-ish. With just a hint of Munch. Some books on color, composition, and... duck hunting?
Duck hunting! Okay.
Emma's really good with the holosculptor, and her imagination is so vivid. Good thing we're best friends, or I might be jealous.
It's kind of a dragon, and it's kind of a kite. And it's kind of T-posing at me to establish dominance. Like, does it really need that much to establish dominance over me, of all people?
Acrylic and oil paints.
Yeah, that's not April.
Those are some of my most recent sketches. Unfortunately, they serve only as a barren testament to my lack of inspiration. Those sketchbooks belong to some of the other students who share the space.
Well, take up your paintbrush and paint, April.
I'm way past finger painting. I need a paintbrush and palette.
Take up your paintbrush and paint, April. All I can see is kind of a blurry smear.
Hiya.
Emma? Hi! I didn't expect to see you here today.
Me neither. Are you busy?
Nah. Well, I am. But I was about to wrap up for today anyway. Why? What's going on?
I have an important message for you.
What's the message?
Believe it or not, girl, but it's from Cortez. He wants to meet you. These are his exact words. Where children visualize their dreams.
Visualize dreams? What's that supposed to mean?
Me? I was hoping you would know.
Did he say anything else?
Nope, that was it. Why does he want to meet you? Oh, don't tell me. You guys are having a secret love affair.
Oh, yeah. We're eloping and flying to Africa tonight. It's all been happening so fast. My heart's a flutter.
Oh, how romantic. I couldn't imagine a better catch than Señor Cortez, the Latin lover.
I think that was sarcasm. I'm 90% sure that was sarcasm on both their parts. I think.
Did he talk to you about nightmares?
No. Why?
I don't know. It's just... my dreams are really starting to bother me.
There you go again with dreams. You're obsessing, April. They're just dreams. Sometimes a banana is just a banana.
And a dragon is just a dragon.
What's dragons got to do with it? Oh, don't tell me you had a dream about dragons.
A dragon. A talking dragon.
With a tremendous
I'm
banana.
I'm gonna regret this, but what happened in your dream?
Well, there was a dragon.
I think we established that already. You had a dream about a dragon.
Not just any dragon, though. A talking dragon.
Yep, we've been through that. Talking dragon covered. What did it say?
She. It was a she, a female dragon.
What, you could tell from the skirt, high heels, and lipstick?
Don't mock me, Emma. She said something to me. Something about being the mother of the future.
She probably said time to get up and go to school, April.
If you don't want to take my dreams seriously, I'll just stop telling you about them.
Is that a promise?
Like you're in any position to make fun of my dreams? Have you looked at your sculptures lately?
Oh, that's low. I'd punch you out if I wasn't so hungry. You want to go get some lunch at the Fringe?
Yeah, this is very much, a middle-aged man attempts to write extremely catty teenager dialogue, and I'm not sure if all of it lands, but...
I'll drop by after I clean up around here.
I'll be there for a while, so bye.
Bring your dragon.
That was not a dream, I think.
But I'm not gonna react to it or anything, you know.
I like my outfit. It's inexpensive, but cool.
Yeah, I'm trying to look at the dragon.
It's Emma's contribution to the exhibition. I have no idea what it is, and neither, apparently, does she. But it looks absolutely beautiful.
Cool, great. Yeah, it is a holoprojector. I mean, it could just be, experimental.
Nice hair color.
Well, thank you. Alright, allegedly we're supposed to meet Cortez, where children visualize the future. Do I know where that is? No. Let's go explore. Here we are at the bridges. There are people.
Man, those guys are in trouble. Don't they know that skateboarding is strictly prohibited in Newport?
Nerd. All right, I think I got a save your game redeem. Even if I didn't, the game is saved now. I really like these water caustics that are kind of glow and pulse down here.
Can you say Death Star?
Yeah, should you say Death Star? I don't know.
If I turn that wheel, would the drain pipes of the universe open up and swallow all solid matter? It could happen. I think people should have the good sense to do that kind of stuff behind closed doors. At least as long as I don't have a boyfriend.
Oh yeah, I'm hydrating. Don't worry about that.
It amazes me why backpackers flock to Newport. You'd think they'd have the good sense to stick to India, Australia, and the near-Earth colonies.
Man, April is really picky about everyone and everything in ways that I didn't notice when I was younger.
Rusty pipes. They're hundreds of years old, installed way back when Venice was an industrial area. See? I know some local history.
I wasn't challenging you, April. Feed the dragon. Yeah, right.
I
cannot...
I've never seen anybody pass through that door. Isn't that peculiar? And if I was Nancy Drew, I might actually care.
Yeah, you're no Nancy Drew, April.
The Fringe Cafe. My home away from home. I really don't mind working there. It's a nice place. I mean, it ranks nice on a scale from begging for food at the bottom to just scraping by at the top. I do not intend to make a career of it.
Well, happily, April's timesheet.
That's my good friend Charlie. He was the first person I met when I came to Venice, and I love him dearly. As a friend.
Complimentary candy jar
for paying customers only. Stan has a habit of taking it out of your salary if you, get the munchies.
Well, that's okay. Nobody will miss one.
I'm sure Stan won't notice if I dig gently into his supply. He's got crates of these in the back.
Oh, less condescendingly dismissive. No. If anything, I suspect she will only get more so. Hey, Charlie. Can you this timesheet? Can I have my paycheck? No, huh? Oh, I can go around back. And what in the hell is this place anyway? Ooh, bread. Is the bread free?
I love the food in this place. We have a great kitchen.
Is the bread free? Can I have some bread? All good. April eats tonight.
Fresh bread. I'm not particularly hungry.
Oh, okay. Well, you know. Yeah, just jam the breadsticks in purse and run.
That's my, well, Emma's friend, really, Marcus. He's a Vava student as well.
Marcus looks like,
Tom's Follies.
Okay. Marcus looks like, that one Saturday Night Live sketch with the really pretentious dudes. Sprockets or something? Hi, Emma.
Settle this one for us, April. When did Roine Dale release Sidetracked?
04, right after the Morning Star exile, those sons of bitches.
With blood on their boots, yeah. Told you so, Marcus.
You said 03.
I was closer than you. 07, and you call yourself a fan.
I don't.
Did you speak with Zach today?
Why?
He was upset. Called you a stuck-up bitch.
He what? You gotta be kidding me. I wasn't even that rude to him.
He'd think so. So that even if you came crawling to his door, he wouldn't give you the time of day. Said you called him an asshole.
Oh, God. I really don't know when to shut my mouth, do I?
Who cares? It's Zach.
He is an asshole.
So what? No great loss.
That's true.
So, what else is going on? What are you doing this afternoon?
What are you doing?
Staying here. What else? I'm meeting a friend later, but that's not until 9. We're waiting for Isabel and then we're gonna eat. But I guess you're not hungry.
No.
Figures. I don't know why I even bother asking.
Alright. Let's pry into Emma's everything.
Who's this friend you're meeting later? Don't tell me it's that guy you were out with last night.
Are you gonna tell me I shouldn't get involved with men like him?
No, of course not. I'm not your... You don't need me to tell you that, Emma.
Well, I wish you would, because you're right. I shouldn't. He's a bastard. But he's so cute and charming and, you know, very good in bed. I just can't help myself, but... He's not a keeper, don't worry about that. It's just this thing, just a fling.
I'm not gonna judge.
Mind if I ask you some questions, Emma?
April will, though.
Like, I don't tell you everything that's going on anyway. Of course you can ask me questions. Like, duh.
Let's see how much is buried in Emma's tree. Just 3.
Did you finish your sculpture for the exhibit?
Pretty much. I'm happy with it, and I know that if I go back and keep working on it, I'll just kill it. So I think I'll leave it alone. You?
You know what? Don't ask. I'm praying it'll finish itself one of these days.
Sure. Could happen. It could so happen. But I wouldn't count on it.
I'll have it ready in time.
Yes, you will, or I'll kick your ass so hard that you'll...
Okay, I got it! Thanks for the inspiration.
Yes, that was the spirit of all conversation trees. And it has blessed us. We now have so many conversation trees.
Did you speak with Charlie today?
Yeah, for a few minutes. Why?
Nothing. Just wondered is all.
April, did he say anything to you at all?
About what?
About... nothing. I mean, I don't know anything. Which isn't true because I don't lie, but he... Ugh, forget it. If we were having this conversation in a movie, I'd be going, like... Shit, girl, get your act together, open your eyes! But I don't think that's a good idea. Not in real life. Because real life has a nasty habit of hurting people's feelings.
I'm not sure how to take that exactly.
What's your, take on Cortez?
My take on Cortez? What's that, like a diplomatic way of saying what the F is this guy's glitch?
Sure, let's go with that one.
You know, I think Cortez is a barrel of laughs, in a good way. Everybody thinks they got him all figured out, you know? Like he's the resident weirdo. But I know that just ain't true. I've talked with Cortez, and the guy is brilliant. He's weird, yeah, and he's up in the clouds, and I think he believes in aliens, which is cool, but girl, he's smart. I mean, I'm not talking professor smart here. I'm talking real life, seen it all, been there, done that, smart. Useful smart. Experienced smart. And, ooh, I gotta tell you, the guy's cultured. Ask him about anything, art, music, movies, books. He's current on most topics, which scares me, because it seems he's always just, I don't know, hanging around doing nothing. He rarely goes anywhere. It's like he's waiting for something. Or someone.
Yeah, maybe Jerry Garcia.
You're bad. No, I don't think he's a doper. I mean, listen to the guy.
Man, they're really, I'll think them up.
The way he says it. No, he's not on Amethyst, that's for sure. And one more thing. He is cute.
He's what?
Cute.
Emma, he's like 60.
Did you ever see his eyes? Those are not the eyes of an old man. And so what if he's 60? He's better looking than most of the guys I date and so much nicer.
Then I think you've been swimming in the shallow end of the gene pool for too long, Emma. I mean, come on, a 60-year-old screwball with a ponytail and an exotic accent? Hello?
Well, we'll see.
Thanks, Emma.
Thanks for what? For talking to you? Girlfriend, what the hell is the matter with you? Snap out of it.
Emma, it's fine. It's just, you know... April's been temporarily possessed by the spirit of an adventure game protagonist.
I gotta run.
See you around, stranger.
She has to ask everybody about everything, and... Also, what the hell is this music?
It's a jukebox, according to Stan. It's an original. Almost 200 years old. I don't know. That looks like a replica to me.
Why is this...
A good replica, but still...
Why is this song going like... at me? No, we gotta...
It took some convincing, but Stan finally agreed to put the jukebox on free play. I'll just choose a track at random.
Great, April, you found the Quake soundtrack. Okay, Stanley, wait a minute.
My
this,
boss, Stan.
That's our boss, okay.
Nah, he's just a callous bastard.
Let's get paid before
I
we leave.
That.
I knew that.
We get paid before we leave.
Here you are, my timesheet.
Don't say that word too loud, sweetheart. You're killing me. Let's see. What is this? Huh? No. Did I sign this? What are you thinking?
So?
At least it doesn't look like it's been forged. Thanks.
Thanks? Where's my money?
Oh, you ain't getting it now. Next week, honey. I write down this amount in my ledger. Don't you worry your head from it.
We could always try and play hardball.
Forget that. I quit.
You're quitting? You can't quit. You work for me. Nobody quits this job, honey.
I can quit. And I'm quitting. I quit.
Damn, woman. You know how hard it is to find people to take a crappy job like this one? I need you.
Just as much as you need the money?
All right. Jesus, I give you your damn money. What was it, $50?
$375, Stanley, cash.
Oh, sure, cash. 300. Are you sure? I pay you guys way too much. All right, give me your CC.
Yeah, this scene really marks this game as fictional. Nowadays, they just rehire somebody at a lower rate.
Thank you, Stanley.
Fine, sure, whatever. Hey, just, I mean it. You free tonight? Wanna pull a shift? Sandra, she out sick and I need a replacement pronto. How about it?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I need the money.
Great, hon. I'll see you here later. Don't forget.
All right, sure. Not only did I not quit my job, I got another bit of money from it. That's good, right? It sounds good. I don't know. Anyway, no Cortez here. Let's see if we can find him. Don't forget. I will absolutely forget. I'm gonna forget. I've already forgotten what you're talking about. I don't remember right now. Right now, I am forgetting. But now there's money on my card. I can, I don't know. Alright, let's head for the subway and see if there's anything fast there. Ooh, maybe I can take the subway somewhere. Actually.
Uh-oh. I have to get scanned. Jumping gates in the Newport subway is a corporate offense liable to get me 5 years behind bars, if I'm lucky.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
Gene scan. Okay,
it's
this
gene
scanner.
It, scans your genes, puts your genetic signature into a database, and allows you through all corresponding gates.
Oh, it just puts my genes in a database. Well, shit, that's no problem, right?
Let's see. According to the instructions, I push a button with a stylized pen, wave my cash card in front of the round thingy, and then stand still for a few seconds. Good. I can stand still.
Yeah, I'm gonna get my jeans scanned, you know? They'll check out my pants. Alright, let's go with just...
I'll get a weekly pass, just in case.
Oh, alright, fine. We'll get a weekly pass. I guess it's good that April has her own opinions on things.
$15 subtracted from cash card. You are now free to travel on all Metroline subways for exactly 1 week.
That's so much cheaper than I would expect.
Genetic forgery is a federal crime. Keep your genes clean. Have a nice day.
Sure, you too. There's something up with the tracks over here.
There's a high-voltage cable running parallel with the rail, and something's gotten stuck between them. looks like a large iron key.
A key? I'm gonna need that, that's obvious. I cannot reach it with the iron glove. Yeah, I guess identical twins do get a two-for-one deal.
I'm not getting on the train until I know exactly where I'm going.
And it seems that I wasted my money because April doesn't want to hop on the train and go anywhere. Anyway, Cortez isn't down the subway. The subway is not where children's dreams come true. That glove has a massive hole in it. Silky, turn it inside out and use the back. Do I really think the game wouldn't kill me? Yeah, I kinda do. This doesn't seem like the kind of game that murders you very easily. If I'm wrong on that, then, you know, I'll start saving twice as often.
It's a pretty mural.
Sorry. Alright, machine is still at maximum pressure. I don't think lodging a loaf of bread in it is gonna help me. Save my game. Save your game. Okay. I guess I can return to my shitty bedroom.
I don't need to make my bed. It's been too hot to sleep with a cover.
Okay, that closes the window. So, let's see. There is that rubber duck out there. Can I attack it with a pin? No. Can I feed it? Can I feed the rubber duck? Yes, I can, actually. And the seagull from Loom is now eating it? Oh. Oh, bye, duck.
Clank?
Yeah, it goes off ratchet. What if I pull this chain? That got me.
It's a plastic coated clothesline.
Clothesline, okay. Clothesline. What can I do with a clothesline? Wonder why she only has three fingers? Because it was 1999. And, rendering was expensive. Alright, what can I do with the clothes? Can I tie this clothes now? No.
It's a rusty old wheel. I'd imagine it turns the water on and off.
A rusty wheel. A rusty wheel. What does one do with a rusted wheel? Not that. What does one do with a rusted wheel? Can't get a better grip on it with, you know, by wrapping the glove around it.
Dad gave me this gold ring on my 16th birthday.
I don't think that's gonna help. Alright, well, that's... Maybe it needs oil. Maybe it does need oil. I don't have any oil. If I see any oily food, I will steal it.
Hi, oh! Duck. Bon voyage, ducky!
Where the duck going? Goodbye, duck. I'll miss you. Yeah, but WD-40 sounds like it would be, like, expensive. So I figure if I can get some greasy food, I can just rub it on the stuff and thing will happen. I don't know. I'm not real clear on the consequences of this one. Well, here's the duck.
It's a rubber ducky. It looks disturbingly familiar. How the heck did it get all the way over here?
Currents? Also, April can just, okay. Alright, we have a duck now. It's deflated. That's sad. What does this do? Oh, we can blow it up. Inflated Band-Aid. What?
The duck's inflated.
Can I deflate it again? No. I kind of want that Band-Aid for some reason. I don't know why. It's an inventory item. And it's... Like, this is the only... Oh! No, I can zoom in on things!
Hey! You! Yeah, you! Hands up! Spread your legs! And do the monkey!
Mildly amusing, but irritating as hell. I'll shut him up now.
Do the monkey! Okay. How would you deflate a duck? Well, ideally you would just pop the little nubbin out. But... Oh, I can just have the Band-Aid.
It's a Band-Aid.
I can hear the sound of this duck deflating, in my inventory. Can I stop it by reapplying? No, that is a permanent change. Okay. Well, I may have just ruined this duck forever. Where the frick is Cortez? I applied mouth to duck. Yeah. I can blow it up, but I don't want it blown up. I want it deflated right now. Yeah, it stops leaks. Presumably it's for the hose that the clamp is on, but I don't give a shit. I'm trying to find Cortez. Dude is somewhere. Okay, this is to the bridges. This is to the subway. Cortez is nowhere to be fucking found.
Newport Transit System. It's not one system anymore, though. All the different lines are owned by different companies. This is the Metro line, and I believe it's run by Vocamba Mercer.
Okay. Alright, just to, like, stop y'all from talking about it, I'll go patch the leak. But you guys are getting dangerously close to spoiler territory.
It's a pretty mural.
Not bad. Yeah, they did not privatize the public transport in England. They privatized the public transport in Venice. But yeah, I can probably use this to fix that, let me take this up. No. Alright. Alright, what if I do this? Okay. And then I can use this to... No? Alright. So I have a fixed work glove. Okay. That's not what I thought that was for.
It won't budge. The pressure's probably too high.
Do I, in fact, have to puncture the tank to get the pressure down? Oh, right, the cables. I have to... No? That's interesting. Maybe I can use the gold ring to make a bridge across the... Yeah.
I hope it doesn't melt or anything. It's alive!
That is incredibly fucking dangerous! Good job, April! That will definitely get somebody killed!
It won't budge. The pressure's probably too high.
Alright, what did that do for me, exactly? Now I can work this thing. Alright, what exactly am I trying to do? This is very, am I trying to get it vertical? Horizontal? Because... Yeah, this is definitely a puzzle, and I'm definitely working on it, but I'm not sure... Alright, well there's... Now I've got that one a half step out of step. That's incorrect. Okay, now I've got like all of them... Well, that would be good if that was what I was going for. Alright, there is a position where only two of them... Oh, that one moves every... Alright. Is it time for logic skills? Hell no, it's time for brute force. I've got these dangerously out of sync, actually. Yes, April, that's fine. I think I fucked this puzzle pretty hard. Can I leave and come back? And, no. Alright. Okay, now I just need to get these two to move. A little bit, and I'll have them all in sync. Naturally, that's not... Okay. Alright, I guess it is time for logic skills. Hold on. Alright. New page. Let's see, the first light moves. Okay, so light one moves, plots 2, 3, and 4. Light 2 moves slots 1, 3, and 4. Light 3 moves slots 1, 2, and 4. Yes, I know, I've been saying, like, light one, light two, light three as a shorthand for the red one. It's the position that the red light is in, 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's what I've been calling out. And light four moves 1, 2, and 3. I just wanted to write that down to be absolutely sure that that was the case, you know? So, given all that, I think I can get them more or less back in sync by doing that. Alright. Now they are all still out of sync, actually. I have managed to get them actually worse out of sync. So, I do know a little bit of logic, but it doesn't help because I'm dumb. Alright, now I just need to not touch. You know, it would help if I knew what I was going for. Like, am I trying to get them aligned vertically or horizontally? I don't know. They were aligned vertically before and it didn't do anything. That's valid. Well, presumably horizontally, yes. But I think I've actually fucked this up so bad. Can I reset this by... No. Alright, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna reload to before I started screwing with this. And I'm gonna try not to break it so bad this time. Autosave. Where was it? Oh no, that was... Alright. Normally I would be whipping through this puzzle, but I am having a really crappy brain day. Horizontally. If nothing else, I'll do them one at a time until they stay like that. Except I can't do them one at a time, ever. This can't be permanently broken. This cannot be permanently broken. There must be a way. How do I get them aligned again? Think, brain. Think. Oh, I just start with them aligned and, now I can ripple effect it down. And then, yeah, you can't move one, you can only hold one. That's true. I can only hold one in place. So it's not like I can fix them all, but I can fuck them all up simultaneously. What if I try to fuck them all up as hard as I can? Oh, no, one more. Unfortunately, I can feel you trying to give me, like, subtle tips. And unfortunately, those don't work on me. So, okay, hold on. I'm gonna draw something out real quick and see if I can, like, sketch this out for just a second. Alright, if I kind of wish I could, like, show you what I'm doing, but at the same time, I think if you, could watch me draw this, it would just look really dumb, actually. No, that's not right. That's not... Oh god, that's incredibly wrong. Okay, so if I do, like, one, two, and then I tap it forward and I do one, all right, okay, I've got it almost there. So if I, one, two, and then I go one, and then I, and then I go one, no, I don't know what the hell you're talking about, Penguin, sorry. Alright, so I'm... got it like that. Can't do anything with... no. Alright, one... two... one, two... one... two, three... Well, that didn't work. I think I'm
mystifying.
I think I'm slowly getting it. I'm just not. Well, I put it back the way it was before. Alright, so starting with vertical. I I move that so that it's vertical, horizontal. But then those are vertical again. Your save the game redemption was a bit late, but okay, I will save. Alright, I've got them all. Alright, and then I move again. But then I move here, so I hold it. Okay. Not quite. Let me reload.
Mystifying.
Yes, it is. Alright, two. So what I need to do is, have it in such a state that some of them are at partial turns, so I can ripple effect them all into the proper place. So I have to have them at partial turns at some points. And that makes sense to me. Okay, and then it's at partial turn. And then they all need to be at different angles to each other. They do. They really do. And then eventually they will all fall into line as I tap through them. Okay, so now I can just go like 1, 2, 3, 4. No. Darn. This will take the rest of the stream. I promise. And then there's that one that's right directly out of sync. So 1, 2, 3, 4. No, 1, 2, 3. Alright, I get them so that they're like this. You know, the simple but painful solution. I don't know shit! What in the last 5 to 10 minutes, Penguin, gives you the impression that I know things? What of any of this has given you the impression? You're assuming that if I just tick each dial once, alternatingly, it'll line up. I mean, that's theoretically possible, like, someday, But it doesn't look like it. Like, it mostly looks like if I pick each dial alternatingly, eventually I will, die. I mean, I could keep trying. Oh wait, this looks promising. Okay, and then I need exactly one to be correct. And then I can just sit on that and spin the others like an idiot. For 2 hours. Oh yeah, like that! That's how I needed it to be. I need something like that to happen. And... oh, yeah. Okay.
I want to go far away!
Can I have my ring back?
The ring seems to be working perfectly as a conduit between the two cable ends.
Okay, so now what? No, wait. Hold on.
It won't... budge! The pressure's probably too high.
Okay, the pressure is so high.
Without the ring, I won't be able to use this, machine. I'll leave it until I finished whatever it is I'm doing here.
What am I doing here? What am I doing hanging around? I should be on that train and gone. I should be riding on that train. What am I doing here then, if not that? Yeah, I solved the machine, but what did that do? What did that do? The pressure is still too high to turn the wheel. What did that do?
It's a rusty old wheel. I'd imagine it turns the water on and off.
What did that do? Was that tank interactable?
The water tank's full.
No, the water tank is not interactable. What the hell did that do? Wait, valve.
It's a pressure valve.
Yes! Can I have my ring, please?
I'm not leaving my gold ring. Somebody's going to have to replace that cable eventually.
Okay, good. Yes, excellent. What the fuck was that for? Well, I got a clamp. And that helps. And you fill up the rubber duck with water. That's a good question. Was there a redemption? Yeah. I'm still getting zero sound effects on my end when people redeem things. For the record, like, no sound effects whatsoever. That is an obvious side effect of, like, having the audio mixer set to handle sound alerts in OBS. It means I don't hear them anymore. I don't know why not. But yeah, okay, let me open Steam and swap to the out. Oh god. Let me reground myself and. No, get out of my way. And enlarge this. And, oh, there's a new Star Trek Online patch. No. Outrun. Get my controller on. Get chat back up. It looked like there was a thing in the tank. That is theoretically possible, and I will check on that next. Right now, this is visible, right? Hold on. Let me... Yeah, that's fine. Alright, So, did you have any requests? As long as I am out running. That's very loud. Yeah, one sec. Is that a bit loud? Okay. I nudged it down.
365 GTS for Daytona. Automatic transmission.
I'm gonna do... Outrun 2. And I'm feeling like... I'm feeling like, just passing breeze. No one should sleep in Tokyo. Yeah, I'm just gonna go wherever the wind takes me. I guess this will close out the stream. The longest journey so far... Not bad. I sort of expected we would already be at the part where I remember stopping, but I don't even remember these puzzles. So it's a little weird that I remember stopping, like, later on past them. But that's how your brain works, you know? You latch on to certain things. And you just don't, you don't think about it. You retain some things, you drop the others. Good time so far, though, I have to admit. It's nice. Yeah, we've got a big glowy white dragon in our dreams. It can't be too bad. Although Cortez seems to think that, seems to think it's bad, but he also seems to think we'll know where the fuck he is, or care. So, you know, go get that, Cortez. That didn't really work out as well as I planned. Yeah, adventure games are adventures. Video games are video games. And we'll probably be doing more video games later. I don't intend to stop playing The Longest Journey. Until it's done. At least I hope not.
What fun!
What fun! What fun indeed. What is the fun? Oh, did Sega do some initial B games? Hell, I gotta get my hand- Well, I would get my hands on those, but they're probably all arcade only. Honestly, though, it's Sumo Digital. It's Sumo Digital that's to blame slash thank for Outrun 2. And I think about that every day of my life. And I wish Sumo Digital were making racing games, like, more. I don't even know if they were involved with the latest Sonic Racing game, the one with the wisps in it. Team Sonic Racing. Did they do that? I know they did the other Sonic Racers. The Transformed line. Sonic and Sega All-Star Racing. Yeah, I love that game. They worked on Team Sonic Racing. That's good. I should pick that game up sometime. Dog, dog, dog. My favorite truck. Dog, dog, dog. Imperial Avenue. Man, passing breeze kind of stalls out past a point, doesn't it? The Imperial Coliseum. The Arc de Triomphe. Me driving sideways. Athenian pillars. Cobblestone streets. An aqueduct. I honestly cannot tell if we are in Rome or France. Or like the Franco-Roman Empire that Eve is set in.
Congratulations!
Either way, we're done under 5 minutes. Yeah, we're in Europe. I just kind of wandered as I felt like. I probably could have gone for E.
Best Outrunners. Game over.
Solid mid-tier performance. Anyway, what am I doing with a controller? I guess we're just gonna save again. Again? Alright, we've got a clamp. We've got some hard candy. A fixed glove. And we don't know where Cortez is. We have no idea. So, next time when we come back, tomorrow or whenever. It will be the search for Quartet, a thingy. Yeah, like a matchbook thingy. Anyway,
it's a pretty mural.
When we come back tomorrow or whenever, someday soon, we will continue the search for Cortez. Cortez probably fucking exists somewhere. We'll find him. Yeah, no, by the way, guys, I still can't hear any sound redeems, and that makes me sad. I gotta figure out, like, what about sound alerts makes it not play when it says OBS, and I don't know, man. Anyway. Yeah, let me just take a quick glance and see if anybody transferable to is on. I could drop you off at Keldon again, I could drop you off at Calyx again, but I think I'm just gonna call it for now. the sound, yeah. Like I said in the tweet, when I announced this, I've been trying a lot of things to enhance the stream, like trying to get better, but sound alerts working better. I've been trying to get like an MP3 player set up and like a scrolling title list. I've been trying just to improve things, improve the layouts. And everything I've done has either, like, backfired or just refused to work, period. And it has pissed me off royally. I am deeply fatigued, and I'm taking a mental break from stream work for the rest of the week. Like, I'm not gonna touch shit. I'm not doing anything. But I will be streaming, like, games, because that doesn't actually require work. That just requires me to show up. Anyway, I'm just gonna go ahead and let you guys float. Have a good night. Enjoy what you do have. And I hope to see you here again. Good night, everybody. And good luck.